Welcome, Shining Star Scholars. We continue our chapel worship series, looking this whole year at how we have a loving Father. We say to God, you are our loving Father who tests us for our good. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. We praise you, Lord, for the gift of salvation and the righteousness that is ours through faith. Thank you for loving us. Through your Holy Spirit, may we let our light shine in all we think, do, and say. This we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen. Let's fold our hands and pray together. Dear Jesus, you died, rose, and went to heaven. Receive our worship. Hear our prayers. Shine on us so we shine for you. Amen. Our message today from God is that we are tested for good. Testing isn't fun, but it's for good. So let me ask you, do you like tests? Nowadays, you probably do it with that Chromebook or computer. Back in the day, this was the tool of choice, a number two pencil. Look at how cool that number two pencil is. It's spectacular. I remember having to make sure we had two number two pencils, making sure they were sharp and filling in these ovals and taking those tests. Back in the day, all we took was Iowa tests of basic skills. Could never figure out why it wasn't in Wisconsin. It was in Iowa. Now you, in 2020, take a lot of tests, a lot of exams, map tests and other tests and checkup tests and all kinds of tests, as well as those big standardized tests that tell not only how well you are doing, but how the whole school is doing. Do you like tests? The bigger question is, do you benefit or do you get something good from those tests? If you talk to teachers, and I get to talk to teachers, they like some of the tests. It's a lot of work to give tests as a teacher, but they like some of them, the ones that help them teach better. They like the map tests where they get it. Feedback right away, and they know what maybe they could have taught better, and they can loop back and teach you. They like those tests because it really helps them do what they want to do, teach you about God's world and not miss anything. But the tests they aren't such big fans of are the tests they do to kind of be able to pass the state test. And you take the test now, and you don't get the results for another year, it seems like. It doesn't help you do anything. Some tests are good and some aren't as good, but for the most part, tests are valuable. It lets us know the facts of where we are, how are we doing, and gives us a plan on how to grow. It's good to be tested. It isn't fun to be tested. In our story this week, we got to see how God, because he loved Abraham and his son Isaac, tested him. He tested him with that tough command to go to the mountain and sacrifice your son that you've waited so long for. And Abraham couldn't figure it out. It didn't make any sense, but he reasoned, well, God could raise him from the dead. This, I can't understand this, but I will trust my God. I will put faith in him, but because he's the same God who kept his promise and will keep his promise to save me. This test, when Abraham was willing to do it, then God provided that ram, showed Abraham his faith, and his son got to see it, and God got to see it. It also prepared him for the future. And for that son, Isaac, he would see that, you know, no matter what, we can trust our God. It was a valuable test. And it helped them both look to Jesus in the future as the ultimate promised son who came to sacrifice himself and was like that ram and substituted himself for us so we wouldn't have to be sacrificed. What about our tests? Abraham was unique. We probably aren't going to get a test like that. But living in a world that's broken, in a world where we can get sick, where loved ones we know get sick and die, accidents happen, car accidents happen, fires take place, natural disasters take place, and we go through all that, what we want to do in life maybe won't happen. Our hopeful plans and what we were really counting on doesn't take place. And sometimes we don't feel like we're children of God. We don't look like it, but yet God says you are. And that's a test, because it doesn't always make sense. Like, but if this was true, wouldn't life be easy? Wouldn't it just be a breeze? We go through tests like that because God loves us enough to test us to keep us close to Him. One Bible passage that comes to mind is from James 1:3. It says, "The testing of your faith produces endurance." So you want to be strong and be able to last and be an amazing person and do courageous things like we hear so many heroes who have gone before us have done. Just think of the amazing heroes. They had to go through a lot of stuff. And God says testing produces endurance. Or maybe from Psalm 34, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but the Lord delivers him out of them all. No matter what we go through, God will deliver us. He's bigger than any problem, and that's our promise. Our tests are painful, but they're for our good. So right now, if you're having a tough time in life, it's really tough. Don't think something weird is happening. Realize that's how God loves you. Just like a teacher and a parent will discipline the scholars or the kids that they love because they love them, they want them to grow. That's what our God does well as the perfect Heavenly Father. When times are tough, you know that God loves you so much because He's training you and blessing you and giving you strength and endurance. Testing by God lets us see how our faith is doing. It also lets us plan for the future and reminds us to cling close to God's Word. Let the Holy Spirit work in us so we can grow and grow and grow and get to where we want to be to serve our God with the best that we can. Now, if you didn't have any tests in your life, well, you wouldn't know the reality. You wouldn't know how to grow. You wouldn't grow through it, and you wouldn't be experiencing the love of our God. So rejoice that you're having a lot of testing, that life is tough. God loves you that much. And know that in all that testing, we fail, we sin, but God has passed every test for us. So that when God looks at us, it's as if we always get an A, as if we always get a perfect score because Jesus has taken our place. Put up those four fingers and say it with me. Jesus died for me. Amen. That's how we know we're God's children. God has passed every test. That's how we get the power to take on the next test. So what does this story of the testing Abraham teach us? First of all, God loves us enough to test us. It's a sign of His love. We learn and grow through those tests. And finally, Jesus passed every test for us in testing. That will be over. It isn't always going to be a struggle like this. When we get to heaven, it's all going to be awesome, and we get there by grace. Look forward to that. So if you know that God loves you by testing you and that you will pass the test because of Jesus, let me hear you say amen. Amen. As we ponder this week, we realize we haven't always passed every test. Let's confess our sins and hear that good news of forgiveness in Jesus. Join me in the park marked all. Dear God, I am sinful. I do not always do what you want. I deserve only your punishment. Forgive my sin because of Jesus. God loves you and forgives you because of Jesus. Jesus died to pay for your sin, and He always did what His Father wanted in your place. As God's children, He now gives you power to live for Him. Amen. Amen. Let's fold our hands and pray, then I'll invite you to join with me in the Lord's Prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank and praise you for being so awesome and wonderful and having ways that are higher than our ways. Lord, forgive us for all the times we can't understand the testing and the struggles and what's going on. But Lord, we ask for faith to trust you. Help us be courageous. Help us work through the difficult times and grow. Help us use those tests for our benefit. Lord, we ask you to bless us this school year as it's kind of been a test already with the different things teachers and parents and scholars have had to do. Use this time to make us strong and ready for anything that comes at us in the future. Lord, we ask you to give us a good attitude and help us persevere and stick to it. We pray this all in Jesus' name. And now join together in the Lord's Prayer. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come. Your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. And forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Receive the blessing from our God. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face shine on you and be gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen, amen, amen.
Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. I wanna magnify your light. I wanna reflect the sun. Cut like precious diamonds with colors by the millions. This is the only world we know, and for now this rental's our home. If we gon' be a reflection, gotta make this third rock glow. Just so you know.
Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shines bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, Jesus, music for the people.
Lights in the city might be more than pretty, pretty. That freaky shine might be more than meets the eye. Anytime you see the sparkle in the dark, you might look deeper, deeper. It might be more than simply fear. Yo, that smile might be joy that's connected to the spirit. The spirit might be contagious. If you dare, you dare come near it. I remember, can't forget. He said you can't second guess. Sparkle as the light reflects. We write and pay it forward checks.
Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, making music for the people. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people to illuminate the show. Light shine bright everywhere we go. Music for the people, Jesus, music for the people.
Light shine bright, light shine bright.
People making music for the people. Light shine bright.